Hello, good day, and welcome back. So today we're going to be looking at how you tell your goroutine that you want them to exit, and maybe they should do whatever cleanup they need to do. Because as you write more and more complex program, your goroutine are not going to be as simple as the one that we write. But that's good if they are. But you might find that you might write goroutine that allocates some resources, maybe open up a connection to a database, or open up a file, and maybe they're writing stuff to that file or reading from the file. You want to say, hey, you know what, that's enough, you've done enough, thank you very much. I need you either stop reading now or stop sending me data or close that file. And the way we've been looking at things is, as we said earlier, when your main function ends, which is that first goroutine that set up to run your main program, your main function, all goroutines terminate. And so we've just been killing things out. So we're going to start there where we do things not the graceful way, and then we look at one way in which you can do things more gracefully. I don't have a name for this goroutine, and I don't remember Robert Pike giving it the name. It's just the concept that's important, that I said from the beginning of this, when we started talking about consistency pattern, is the concept that's really, really important to recognize. All right, so let's do it. So basically, I just described all of this. This is where we want to put a goroutine to clean up properly before exiting, and what we're going to do is be using an input channel, sort of a quit channel, to signal to that goroutine. Now, you can use your imagination here. You can say, well, if I have a channel to a goroutine, I might actually send more than one message. I could say, you know what, I want you to slow down how you send me data, or maybe I want you to send me a different pattern of data. So basically, once you have that channel to the goroutine, you can think of it as using it to communicate to that goroutine, right? So in this example, I'm just going to use to send one value, which is going to be to exit, but you can certainly use your imagination, okay? You're not limited in any way. All right, so enough talking. Let's go look at the code. So let's do it. Go load up here. This is so small, but let's open it up. And you want to see things kind of big. So hopefully this is not big enough for you guys to see. Okay, all right, so this is where we left out the last time, but this is not what I want to work with. As a matter of fact, you know what, I'll rewrite it. There's a lot of code in the previous section that we really worked with that I can do. So let's say we have a goroutine call, let's say chatter. this is just a goroutine that talks, and there's some string, and what it does is it returns a goroutine on which you can read from, channel string, and what it does is it out channel is made, channel of string, and of course we're going to return that out. And what it's going to do here is set it to go, func, don't even need to take anything. And basically what I'm going to do in this channel is going to sit there forever, and I'm going to spend some time waiting, so time that's sleep. And how long am I going to sleep? Some random time, so time that duration. And we've done seen this before, times time that nanoseconds, right? And I'm going to get this from ran that int, and maybe, I don't know, 100 nanoseconds or something, whatever. So I'm going to spend some time sleeping, and then I'm going to send out a value in this channel out, and what I'm going to send is, you know, the string I got back was, I'm not trying to do anything. So I'm just going to send back whatever string I got back. So basically, I'll announce myself, basically. All right. And so here, what we're going to do is, let's say we have a chatter zero. It's going to do some chattering. And we're going to call, you know, Bob. I said Bob in the chat, I think. Something that brings is not synced up with my fingers. And okay. And we have J, and we have N, and you just get N however you like, and Mary, for example. And so this is that, 2, 3. And so these guys are chattering, and of course we can use our fanning pattern to read from them, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna sit here and basically, maybe we should. So let's do this. So I'm gonna say, go funk, let's go read from those guys and put it in a new channel. So let's do the final output channel as equals the make channel of string with a fanon channel. And so what I want you to do is let's do it properly. I was saying that again this one we know I'm gonna do something different way. There we go. So funk, fanon, it's just going to take my channel there and C1, C2, C3. And there's a channel that I could have reached string from. And it's going to return the channel on which I can read the string. And so like I said, I kind of changed my mind midway. So let's see, what does this do? Well, so it takes a channel, right? Of course, we know it has to, it's going to return that output channel to us. But we want it to launch some goroutine that's going to go read from this channel and put on that output. So it's going to be go funk, just loop over reading from those channels and putting it on out, right? So you're going to do from C0 and that's going to be it. And so I kind of shortcut how I did it in the last video, but last video I kind of did like, so let's see, what is it complaining about now? Send onto that channel a value that I read from this channel. So so I'm saying read from this channel and send it over there. So let's do that. Copy, I'll use a variable in between, so that's why it looks so weird. And so this is gonna be 3, this is gonna be 2, and this is gonna be 1. So basically I'm saying here in my final, launch a goroutine to read from this channel, read a value from here, and then send it on to there. Alright? And I do 4 photos, and of course here is a return. Alright. What is this complaint about? Complaint about not use, of course, because I didn't call my final yet, so I say out equals to final C0, C1, C2. Alright, and basically what I want to do, and in fact I could, you know what, I can really make this a lot simpler by not having to do a fanon. But let's ignore a fanon for this example. Let's just ignore a fanon. Sorry, I changed my mind yet again. Alright, so what I'm going to do is just say do a for loop, select on each channel, so case, I'm going to try and read some value V from channel 0, and then of course if I can read it, then I want to do FNT that print line, very simple, okay, And now I'm going to just do this 3 more times for my different channels. So let's keep it simple. And this is effectively better, right? I mean, actually, I'm writing it to my output instead of writing it to the automatic channel. That's why I decided to simplify it, because I don't have to, again, loop around on that channel. So, okay, so this is going to create our 4 chatters, and then we're going to take values from them as they send it to us, and print it out, okay? I don't know why this is giving syntax error in the expected chatter. Where is the parentheses? Extra parentheses. So go here, click this frame, define that. There you go. Maybe that's old, so let's try and run it and see. So go run main, and as you can see, it's just running forever, right? Good. All right, so maybe what we want to do is, you know, of course, we have this going like this forever. So maybe what we want to do is to do this for only a period of time. So we want to say, do a timeout here, right? So we want to do, wait for some time, so time that maybe sleep. I'm going to try and read, but it might be in a channel, but it might be an after. So I'm going to sleep for time that 200 times time that seconds, for example. Okay? So I'm going to let my program run for 2 seconds. But I'm never going to get here because this is in a for loop. So I want to stick this in a goroutine. We know to do that. When you want stuff that's going to keep running, you stick it in a goroutine. So go FUNC, bump, and it doesn't click anything. So I launch a goroutine that's going to be viewing from my, doing basically my fan end, but you know, it's not doing it to a channel. Because I simplify it, it's just going to F to the standard out. And then after this pass here, it's going to wait here, sleep. And so I should expect my program to end. All right? So it's running. And then after 2 seconds, I'm not going to touch the keyboard. So you're not going to see that interrupt signal. And it should have ended by now. All right? I'm going to interrupt that. What did I miss? So go launch those, go launch this, so read from there, come here and sleep for, 200 seconds, way too long, 2 seconds, sorry, we're 2 seconds, alright, so I got that, and then I should see it end, and there we go, it ended after 2 seconds, but remember, when this ended, it killed my 5 goroutines that I have running, these 4, and this guy, it just killed them. You know, mercilessly. So what I would like instead is for my goroutine, when I sort of ready for things to exit, is it should send a message to my goroutine telling them, hey, guys, it's time to quit. And we can do that by creating a quit channel. So let's say quit. Equals to, come on, make channel, and it could be anything, right? So I'm going to do bool just to use bool, but, and it doesn't matter what value I send. And so what I'm going to do is give to my channel, and there's the name, and also, hey guys, there's your quit channel, right? So you take an extra parameter, which is this quit channel, and I want you guys to send me stuff, just like before, but I also want you to be monitoring that quit channel. And basically, so here's the chatter. You also get a quit channel, right? And we're gonna say that was just a channel to read values from, and it's a Boolean channel. And what I want, guys, is, you know, not only are you just sending me values, but also to try and to check that quit channel to see if, you know, if I want you to stop. So how do we do that? Well, they have 2 channels, right? They have to send in a channel if I'm ready to receive, and they also have to check this channel. So we know that it must include a select statement. And so case, right? If you can read from, if it's true, that you can read from the quit channel, then what I want you to do is actually do some kind of cleanup work. We don't have any cleanup work to do here. And, you know, they go to this 4 week, okay? Or return, whichever. And in the case that, you know, there's nothing to read from the quit channel, well, the default behavior I want is for you to just, you know, sleep a little bit and then send me some values. Does that make sense? So, try to read something from the quit channel. If you can't, or if I didn't tell you to quit, then by default, just go sleep a little bit and then try to send. Now, we could do it the other way and say, if you can send, which is probably better, actually, is to say, if you can try and send a value, please try and send a value, right? And if you can send, then send a value as, and then sleep a little bit. But either way, you know, if you can send, send the value, then sleep a little bit. We have a number of ways we can do it. We can also, because I can always be on the other side ready to receive. So there can be some work that you might need to do this, to do here, to make sure that it works exactly the way you want. So here I'm saying, if you can't read from the quit channel, then send the value and then go sleep a little bit. And after you sleep, go back and try waiting to see, go back and try to see, I set the quit before you try sending another value. And if you can't, then send another value. So you have to, you know, definitely tweak this possibly. It could work still, but, or even with the default, it could still work. You know, hope that default just now says, if I didn't tell you to quit, the default thing to do is sleep a little bit, then send the value. That should also work, right? But definitely test your code and make sure you get the right behavior. All right, so those are all my chatters are gonna operate. Now, here, when I reach the end, instead of just deciding to exit main, what I'm gonna do is on the quit channel, I'm actually gonna send some value. So I could send anything. It really doesn't matter. I'm gonna send in values to my channel, but I don't care what the value is. All I care is that, oh, something came, and therefore it means that I should quit, okay? So don't read this as not really meaning to quit, okay? Because my goroutine here, I'm not reading the actual quit value. But so as you don't really get confused about it, let me just make them all true. So quit, quit. All right. So I send that. I need to send 4 values because I have 4 channels that are reading from that channel, 4 goroutines that are reading from that channel. And if I don't send enough, main is going to end and all my goroutines are going to end, but not all 4 of them is going to get the nice, you know, the nice treatment of being able to clean up. So that's why I'm sending 4 values. And so you can make this better whereby using, you know, like if you're using a slice or something, you can use a slice, this length of the slice to just loop around here and send these so that it makes sure that you send enough. And then in the next video, we're going to learn about another way of your goroutine telling you to quit and that they finished doing their work and how you can know that. And you can use something like a wait group. So there are a number of things you can do, okay? But this is just one way. So this is us trying to tell them that, hey, I've had enough of you, your work thing. Here, we for our fan-in, because I didn't write a real fan-in, I am use a quit channel. So this one is still going to be terminated mercilessly, but mercilessly. And but I could do the same thing when I write a fan-in. I could have just passed in a quit channel and said, okay, try to read from these guys, and then also, you know, check the quit channel to see if it's time to quit. All right, so let's do that. The other thing we can do is, let's put here fnt that print line and say, I am quitting. Quitting. Okay, or maybe more like this. S plus. Okay. Okay, so we should see Mary is quitting, you know, Sam is quitting, that sort of thing. So let's run it and see if that's what we see. So run, and yep, and there we go, right? And you see Bob is quitting, Mary is quitting. And even though we got a message here at the end that looked like it came from Bob, that's just a matter of the order in which things are printed out, because we have several goroutines. You know, we have this guy that's running here, and so he, there was still a value on the channel from Bob that he still had to pull off, and he was able to write out before the entire program exit. But at least you see how we were able to tell our chatters to, hey, you know what, we're not going to terminate you just like that, give you an opportunity to quit, all right, to clean up. So hopefully this makes sense. Again, if it doesn't, it's just one. It's my example is slightly different than the example you'll see, but the general idea is still the same. Give the channel, give your goroutine a channel on which you can send message to them. Again, like I say, you can use this to send multiple different types of messages. You're going to say, okay, let's read the message off the channel. If it's true, means quit. If it's false, means speed up or whatever. If you're using strings or integer, we could send multiple messages to our goroutine to, you know, help them do this right thing. All right, so I hope you can see that. All right, take care. Thanks for subscribing. If you've already subscribed, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, and please help me spread the word. If you really like what I'm doing, you're learning, please help me spread the word. And of course, if you have suggestions and so on, I appreciate that too. So take care, and thanks for giving me your time. See you in the next video.